has been marinating in a teriyaki marinade since Tuesday. All right. Trust me, you marinate for a couple days, it's going to come out good, regardless of what you marinated in. All right. Now, the very first thing you do is you turn on the grill. All right. Alright, you open the alternator, make sure it's all the way to the left, righty-tighty, lefty-loosey, and all that wonderful stuff. Turn on at least two burners. Now see, this is just to clean it, you put it on high. Okay, now, see that? So you gotta get rid of that, The temperature's gonna skyrocket here. Remember, safety first above anything else. All right. Oh crap, we forgot to take this. We forgot to put this back in. Yeah, I'll wash it later. All right. Now. So how's everyone doing so far? Alrighty then, now I gotta get my tablet. Don't know where that's at. Right there. Gonna play some tunes while I wait. By the way, Dad. Whoops, sorry. That there's my smartwatch. And trust me, my smartwatch is huge. Alright. Now, when cleaning a grill, it's always a good idea to have a bottle of water with you. Spray bottle, to be exact, right there. I'll show you why. Right now, that thing's cleaning. The usual preference is when it stops smoking, it's clean. But, I say double check always to see if it is clean. Ooh. Because the reason why is because once it stops smoking, there's nothing else for it to clean. That's the main reason. Alright. Oh man, whatever was cooked in there last is smelling good. Alright, now watch, see? Let's see if I can get that. Right there. Now, if you get the Lempho LEMT smartwatch, download the Windows 10 launcher, or the WinX, as it's called. Come on. Alright. Right there. Now it's a little slow. I guess you can call it like of a concept type watch. But the coolest feature is actually the fact that I could actually do video calling on it. I'm trying to find a way to set that up as soon as I do. Alright, now I'm going to play some tunes. Ooh, Ozzy Man has... Ooh. If you haven't checked this guy out on YouTube, you should. Ozzy Man, he's cool. Matogelic as well, he's funny. He's a good chess YouTuber. That there's a picture of my girlfriend. Beautiful lady. Let's start out with a little bit of Gordon Lightfoot, Sundown. Gotta turn that volume up all the way. Gotta start off with some mellowing type of... Alright. See? Now. See? See, you want to get the a scrub brush and with the metal bristles with the long handle. You want to keep your hand away from the flame, or as far away from the flame as possible. Alright. Now, if the fire's getting too high, like that, you take the spray bottle. When I get feeling better and I'm feeling no pain. See how it does that? Now, at first you might think it's not working because it's making the flame go higher. To a certain extent, you're right, because there's grease in there. Yeah, that's going to take a while to clean, so. Ooh, yeah, look at that smoke go by. Sometimes I think you care when I find you creeping around my bedstead. Now, I remember one time before we got this grill, I was cooking on it. Next thing you know, it got to like 650 degrees way too fast. And even 700 and going like holy shit, what the hell? Come to find out there's something messed up in the fuel lines. And the flames are coming at the top, down the bottom, left, right, back. I'm like, uh-oh. Now, if something like that ever happens to the point where the flames are going completely out of control, the very first thing you do is you close the alternator that's on the propane gas grill. Okay? That's on the propane tank, because if not, you could have a house fire. Sometimes I think it's a shame. Feeling better when I'm feeling no pain. Alright. Take care if I find you creeping around my next day. See? So like spray the bristles. That way it makes it a little bit more effective. Scrubbing. Never losing again. Fuck. Yeah, there's a chunk of ground beef. All right. Yay, I got it. Alright. Because the thing about it is, you want to get a clean grill as you cook on it. Just think about this, like, would you rather eat off a clean plate or a dirty plate? This is pretty much the same concept, except for you're cooking on something clean instead of something dirty. Or at least sanitized. See? Now, once again, you take this water bottle. Alright. Let's listen to something else. Anyone have any requests? Ooh, how about a little bit of Ronnie Dio? His early work. Listen. Yeah, this is Ronnie Dio's early work. Before he even got into rock music. Well, this is rock music, but like a different variety of it. Yes, he brings love from you. So always remember this, make sure the grill's clean first before you even put anything under. Or at least sanitized. Some people prefer a charcoal grill. Personally, I don't care as long as it's a grill. Ooh, 550 degrees. You can see the flame right there. What to do, what to say. Alright. Yeah, we cooked. We had hamburgers on the last time we were here. Actually, cheeseburgers. The fuck? There we go. That's something looking weird. Yeah, this is gonna take a while to clean. Holy cow! Woo! No time for pleasure. Sunday at the park. Alright. See how the flames are going crazy everywhere? Your flame defense. Oh boy, yeah. He keeps asking for you. He keeps asking for. Never seen him clacked up on the back before.
Hey, bro, I'm here. Can you open the door? What's the password? Let me in, come on.
Sorry, no entry.
Well, good. I guess you don't want Mom plus 9 to suggest me.
Oh. Yes, correct.
Sorry.
Sonya is correct for the password.
It's kind of a stupid commercial, so he just told us what his password is. Bada ching. Alright. This is an hour year. This is something different. Is this the Italian version? Man, that man's voice is just made of talent. See now, after it's clean, you want to get it down to about 350 or anything less. Because if you put anything on too high of a heat, it's not going to come out as tender or as good. So you just want to calm it down a bit. Yeah, just. Poor lonely Mr. Misery. Story of my life is not worth reading. Alright, now it's starting to get a little bit better because the flames are not going everywhere. So now I could try to scrape this a bit. Oh, I spoke too soon. I'm getting the correct camera angle, but. See that right there? I'm gonna get rid of that. So always remember this, regardless of what you're doing, with cooking, injuries can happen, injuries have happened. I've burned my fingers a couple of times, but as long as you practice safety, the injuries will be to a minimum. Alright, you want to try, the goal is to try to prevent any injuries from happening at all. Like I had spaghetti sauce, I think it was on my left hand, is either that or, let me see now. No, it was on my right. So I was like stirring it around with like a. I guess it's Groundhog's Day, I'm always in. No, it was my left because I was stirring around to the left. And for some, I forget what I was doing with my. I was stirring around with my right hand. And I forget what I was doing with my left, and spaghetti sauce splattered right up on here. Alright, yeah, I gotta scrub the back there. Last night I heard some crazy sounds coming from the other side of town. I'm trying to walk on down to see what I could see. Sorry if I'm not getting the correct angle. Alright. There's girls everywhere. There's no street that can come back. Now, while it's in its final stage of cleaning, I might as well get the steak and pretty soon we started rolling. I made some mac and cheese in there. Simple, like Ragu has a jar of like double cheddar, as it's called. You just cook up the macaroni and just pour the jar of cheddar sauce in there and stir it around and serve. Alright. I made the iced tea and the Kool-Aid. Strawberry Kool-Aid, by the way. You can see the little seeds in there. Right. I'm going to try my best to open this without shaking the camera too much. Mm-hmm. For those who are wondering, I actually put a video on YouTube about when I was... when I was doing a Trust.com app on this smartwatch. It's pretty darn cool. Swing. Now for steak, stuff like that, it's best to use a pair of tongs. Alright. Now, I'm going to be using the right side, so... the thing you do with the left side is you turn them off. Now, with the right side, just turn them on low because you don't want on, once again, you don't want on too high of a heat. Like, whenever you're marinating anything, try to compress as much air out of it as possible. And if you have one of those vacuum seal bags, do that. Now, the idea here is, see, it's 550, yeah. Gotta let it cool down just a little bit longer. Sun will never shine again. And each day, you don't have to do this, but each day just do something like this. That makes the steak a little bit more tender because it's like have you ever got a black eye or a fat lip? It feels more tender than what it was before, right? Yeah, same theory. Alright. Because I'm not using the entire grill, I don't need to have these two on. Just these two at the most. And besides, let's just say it starts to flame up way too high on this side. Put it over right here. That's it. The dying sailor. Hey, if you guys want any requests, just tell me. I'll type it in here and... see, it's calming down. You want to get it to about 350. If I cook a steak in the oven, I put it in the oven for about 300. Cook to a medium. Now, because this is actually a pretty thin steak, alright. So I'm making it look thicker than what it is. But because it's like a pretty thin steak, no more than 18 minutes. All Alright. Alright, 400 degrees. Good. Keep going. Now, when you put something in the oven, say 400 degrees, it's usually like a pizza you get at the store. Now, if you happen to live near a super Walmart, hey, Lucky Cratcher D, how's it going? If you happen to live next to or close to a super Walmart, you get one of the pizzas from the deli section. They're about $8. They are filling, they taste great, they're phenomenal, and they are definitely worth their money. Just to let you know, here's the ribeye. Alright. Almost time. This torture is running through my mind. No, in the future depends on what I find. Alright, I'm gonna go inside and get the pair of tongs. Because my instincts tells me I'm going to need the tongs almost immediately. Alright. Alright, let me see if there's any tongs in the dishwasher here. Clean. Alright. Now, either A, a pair of tongs that are really, really long, or B, tongs that are completely metal. Because if you have, let's just say this had like a wooden handle to it. It's like metal grips. You're going to be looking for a new pair of tongs after it starts burning. Alright. Now, it should be... Alright, drop below 350. Now, I'm going to try to find a way to... trying to find a good camera angle. Alright. Alright. Now, I prefer these little Ziploc bags. Whichever one you prefer. Oh, smells good. I'll be back. Gotta throw this in the trash and wash my hands. Alright, just give me another minute. I'm gonna go fill up my glass with water. I'm back. Sorry about that. Always stay hydrated too, because it can get quite hot in this thing. Oh, good. It's staying below 350. What I like. See? Now, to marinate it, here's what I do. Like, I use a fork. I use a fork to poke a lot of holes in the steak. Or whatever piece of meat you use. On both sides. Then I sprinkle on a tad bit of salt or like nature seasoning, whatever. But nothing too much because you don't want the flavor to overwhelm anything else. All right. Hey, if you have any requests, let me know. Anyway, now, the reason for the salt or nature seasoning, whatever, is because whatever you're using as the flavor, that'll help soak it in and that'll help bring more flavor into the meat. All right, every so often check on it. And then what you do is, as you put it into like the storage bag, like I was showing you before. The last day. 138 on there. Okay, all right, fair enough. All right. Because the reason for poking the holes is because that way, whatever you're using to marinate it in will drop down into the meat. Into like the center instead of just the surface. Then the salt helps absorb the flavor of whatever you're using to marinate it in even more. Stuff like that. So, and when you... okay, sorry, when you marinate it, you get one of those storage bags and you try to compress as much air out of it as possible. Because you don't want the air, you want the flavor. Alright. And that's pretty much it. Just marinate it for a few days. It doesn't even have to be teriyaki. It could be barbecue sauce. It could be Worcestershire sauce. You can marinate chicken and Italian salad dressing. Whatever you prefer, you know. You can come up with anything. Some people have marinated, like, those little ham steaks and pineapple juice. And it comes out quite well. I've done it myself. It's like, whatever your little heart desires, because as long as you follow the basic steps of marinating, the only thing that will limit you is your own imagination, is yourself. All right, gotta keep a constant eye on the temperature, because that there is key. Oh yeah. Whew. Oh, good tune. Hi, our year it is. Trust me, regardless of what genre of music Kanye West has done, it's been phenomenal. We tell you about this year. We are here. Yeah, like nothing more than like maybe 16 minutes. Because you don't want to cook a steak well done. However, the steaks that could be cooked well done are like, and that could still be tender are ribeyes, strips, filet mignons, stuff like that. Even a chuck eye filet, maybe. But that's about it. But like, in other words, if you cook a steak well done, like. Alright, let's just say I had two of these. Same exact size, same exact thickness, marinade, and same exact marinade. I cooked one well done and the other one to a medium. The one that's a medium is going to be more tender than the one that's cooked well done. Together. Yeah, so Now, see, I think I like both propane gas grills and charcoal. I think charcoal's better to train on because you don't have control of how high the flames are going. But here you have control because bam, bam. So like if you can train where you don't have as much control over it, imagine how well you do when you do have control over it. That's a good tip. Unit brought us together. Alright. Alright. 43. Name it,
Want a brain better? Unlike ordinary memory supplements.
Now. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Definitely looking good. Now, gotta check see. Alright, 143. So, about 151. See, another thing is also, all depends on how you store your steak. Because if you marinate it, you can have it in the refrigerator for a week. And it'll never go bad. Because whatever you're marinating it in, it acts as a preservative. Sort of. Now, if you freeze the steak, you cook the steak even longer because obviously the same time won't get it as cooked. Now always remember this, because that stuff has touched raw meat, don't ever use the same plate. Unless you wash it. Okay? Because, hey, what you want is you want a good, great taste in steak. You don't want to get sick. Or you don't want to, correction, you don't want to take a chance of getting sick. Well, yeah, you don't want to get sick. You don't want to take the chance of getting sick. Because then it's not as fun. Alright. Here, I'll be back. I'm going to get myself another glass of water. Alright. I'm back. Yeah, always keep yourself hydrated. Alright, 350, that's good. Huh? Alright, Hey, would you like to listen to a little bit of Aerosmith? Whoops, sorry, my bad. If so, just let me know. Alright, let me see. Actually, you know what? I'll listen to this first. Grand Funk Railroad. All right. Yeah. I like listening to oldies, you know. Oldies, heavy metal, rock, flying car. Everything that a man can want. See, you got more control. Next week I'm thinking about making strawberry pancakes. That's pretty darn good, because what you do is use a blender, cut up some strawberries, maybe a little bit of water into it. Not a lot though. You don't want to use a lot. You make a strawberry puree out of it. And you mix it into pancake mix. And then you cook that as the pancake. It's good. When my baby kisses me, my heart becomes filled with desire to wrap the loving arms around me. Oops, sorry, my bad. Yeah, see, if it was thicker, it'll take longer to cook. Because it's not so thick, let's see if I can get the thinness and. That doesn't mean it's not going to be great. Some kind of wonderful. Yeah, 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 yeah. She's some kind of wonderful. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now I'm going to go and get myself a knife and fork just to test, see how far done it is. I've got to be somebody. Alright. Knife and fork. Here we go. Sorry, my bad. Because when it comes time, like when the song is over, I'm going to test it. It's always a good idea just to cut off just a tiny little piece. It's probably medium right now. I always cook my boneless rib eyes to a medium. I try not to overcook them. Sometimes I do. Like one time, last week, I overcooked it and cooked a little bit too fast. And the one side came out a little bit on the tough side. But thank God I got to the marbled side. Oh, that was good. It's kind of disappointing, the one side. Alright. Alrighty then. Oops, sorry, my bad. Okay, now. Perfect. Even though I'm an affiliate, I still consider myself a noob when it comes to streaming. Okay, it's done. Okay, now. Now, see this? When turning off the grill, the very first thing you do is you close the alternator. And by doing that, you turn it all the way to the right. Remember, righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. Once it's turned all the way to the right, then you turn off the, Okay, well, this is the end of the stream. Thank you for stopping by, Lucky Crafter D. I appreciate it. And whoever else did, because there were two people watching at one point. You guys have yourself a good night. Oh, yeah, I'll be streaming around 8 o'clock. I'll be playing chess while listening to some cool tunes. All right, and you guys have yourself a good night. Peace.